Looking to become a Chicago condo owner, want that awesome view, all the amenities, and be close to everything without breaking your budget? Well, in this video, I break down everything you need to know before deciding whether or not you should purchase a condo in Chicago, Illinois. So stay tuned. What's happening, everybody? This is Austin Weiss, your go-to real estate home advisor right here in the Chicagoland area. I help a ton of families buy, sell, and invest in real estate. So if you're planning to move physically or just move your equity, reach out to me by phone, text, email, and days, nights, weekends. I would love to have a conversation with you to help you in any way possible. And don't be shy. If you're watching my videos, make sure to leave me a comment down below. Smash that subscribe button, tap that bell, and definitely hit the like button, because that all helps my videos reach out to more people just like you looking for awesome real estate advice when considering making a move anywhere in the Chicagoland area. Condos offer the rewards of homeownership with less maintenance, the ability to live in a hot and desirable neighborhood, and you won't have to deal with your crazy landlord who likes to take out the trash at 3 a.m. only wearing his underwear and UGG boots. Yes, this is a true story from someone who I recently helped purchase a home. Because the Chicago market for real estate is so diverse, sometimes making a decision can be very tough. Now, like anything, there are upsides and downsides to almost any living options in Chicago. So in this video, I'm covering the five things you should know before making a purchase on a condo in the city of Chicago. Now, I'm going to start with number five, making my way all the way down to probably what's the most important, which is number one. So make sure you watch until the very end. But without any further delay, let's hop right into number five. Condo affordability. Now, average costs for condos are typically more affordable than single family homes. That will again be dependent on the neighborhood and the type of building you're looking to purchase in. However, there are some extra costs on top of the mortgage and property tax that make owning a condo more expensive, which include fees for pets, storage units, a one-time move-in and move-out fee. Now, you also have homeowner's insurance on top of your mortgage and property tax payment that should be lower for a condo than a single family house. I would also recommend budgeting for interior maintenance and any updates you wanna make. Now, special assessments. This is something that is very important to know about. Basically, major renovations are done to a particular building and funds are requested from condo owners if there are not enough banked reserves. So that's definitely something to keep in consideration, because that will increase your monthly payment. And last but certainly not least is the HOA fee. So this is not tax deductible for your primary residence, but they are for an investment property. And that'll take us right into number two, the amenities, those luxury items the HOA fee will cover. So first and foremost, the doorman. If you buy in a building with a doorman, I'd highly recommend that you befriend this person, because it will come in handy in the long run. Also, the fitness centers are fantastic, especially if you can get one that overlooks the skyline. Going off of the skyline, rooftop balconies, you'll have front row tickets to the air and water show, pools, grill and chill areas. I've also seen cleaners, libraries, a party room. So basically, if you don't have enough room in your condo, you can rent out the party room in your building and entertain and wine and dine your guests. I've seen game rooms, billiards, basketball courts, and in the parking garage, I've even seen self-serve car washes. So if you can get some of these great amenities and you'll use them, that's the key part. If you're not gonna use them, don't buy in a building with a higher HOA that has some of these. But if you are going to use them, you pretty much never have to leave your building. Going off of that, number three, consider your lifestyle. Owning a condo is different from a single family house. For instance, there's no exterior maintenance. You don't have to worry about your yard, raking leaves, wild animals, like finding a fox den in your backyard when you first buy your house, like I discovered. You're also not going to have to worry about structural items such as your roof, siding, and windows. You will, however, have to consider sharing walls, ceilings, and floors with your neighbors. Now, every condo association has rules that each owner has to live by, known as the covenants, conditions, restrictions, and easements. These include what types of pets you can own in that building, the parking, the noise levels, internal improvements you can make to your unit. I highly doubt that a condo association is going to allow you to jackhammer your floor into your neighbor's ceiling below you. Also, older buildings may not have as much noisy neighbor reducing insulation, so that's also something to consider. Hey, if you have any questions or comments about anything I've talked about in this video or any of my other videos, you can always leave me a comment down below. I will make sure to read through those, answer them to the best of my ability. If you like this video, make sure to smash that like button. It helps my videos reach out to more people just like yourself. All right, so moving on to number four is the mortgage requirements. They're gonna be slightly different standards when purchasing a condo than there would be for a single family house. And first and foremost, when you're shopping for a home, a condo, any type of real estate, you should be getting a pre-approval before you ever start your home search, before you ever step foot in a house. You want to figure out who your lender is going to be, because that's also going to be going on your offer contract, and which loan program you're going to be using right now, because interest rates have gone up considerably over the last 6 months or so. There's certain programs that will help you save tens of thousands of dollars, and I want to make sure that you're taking advantage of that when purchasing a condo or any other real estate here in the Chicagoland area. Now, when purchasing a condo, there will be some additional paperwork at the very least, and you most likely will get quoted for a slightly higher interest rate by your lender. This is due to some restrictions and assessments by the HOA, which lenders consider high risk. Now, if you're a VA or an FHA buyer, so those are government-approved loan options, there's certain buildings that are approved for those types of loans and certain buildings that are not. So when you're getting deep into your search, you're going to want to make sure you save yourself a ton of time and only look in the buildings that have approval for those loan types. And finally, one of the most important things that you could possibly do before signing on the dotted line to finalize the purchase of your condo is do your homework on the HOA and the management company. It's often said a good management company will never ask its residents for additional assessment fees. So make sure that you understand what's going on with the financials and the HOA meeting minutes before you ever finalize the purchase. Myself and the attorney that you choose to work with for your home purchase will definitely ask for all these documents and go over anything that looks suspicious. Now, I talked about special assessments earlier in the video under number two, amenities. Basically, what's going on is if the building needs certain updates and there's not enough money in the reserves, the management company may ask the owners for some additional fees per month. So you want to find out if the building has any plans to do any repairs or maintenance on the building in the near future. If so, you want to alter and make your offer reflect that. See if the seller would be willing to come down on their price, offer a credit to help pay for that, or at the very least, decide to walk away from that purchase entirely. Going off of that, keep track of rent capacity. The ability to rent your condo could be valuable if you plan to upgrade your space in the near future or want to build your property portfolio, but a building with high renter's occupancy can be negative consequences such as obtaining financing, impact on the value, dealing with transient neighbors who don't take care of common areas as much as an owner would, and difficulties selling that particular unit someday. If you have any questions about anything I spoke about in this video, or you have plans of making a move anywhere in the Chicagoland area, you can always reach out to me by phone, text, email, days, nights, weekends, and I would love to connect with you and help you in any way possible. But until next time, I'll catch you guys later.